What's up, guys? JFM here, welcome back. Today, I have four incredible shader packs to show you that will change the look of your world as you know it. So yeah, here we are, and as you can tell, my world is looking very, very, very weird. Extremely weird. Absolutely incredi-weird. Yes, I did just make up that word. The reason it looks so crazy is because this is using one of four shader packs that absolutely bend reality and make Minecraft the weirdest looking game of all time. So I thought I'd show you guys some of these, and let's go ahead and start the showcase. The shader you have been looking at and that I'm using right now is called the Inception shader, and it's basically inspired by the movie, and I might show a clip or something like that to show you where this comes from, but basically the world ahead of you gets bent upwards into the sky. So, very, very, very cool. Like I said, there are four of these packs. Three of the other ones, well, let's go ahead and read them off. There is a parabolic shader, there's an Animal Crossing shader, and then, of course, there is a hallucination shader as well. So, very, very cool stuff. This is the Inception one in a medieval world. Pretty cool. I'll go ahead and show you guys what it looks like in a modern world now. So, believe it or not, this isn't even one of the craziest ones. They definitely get a lot weirder. So this is this. But let's go ahead. Let's try one of the new ones we talked about. Let's go ahead and try, I don't know, the parabolic shaders. Let's see what that does. Now, this parabolic shader is made to make the world seem round, kind of like Earth. It's a little bit too round to be so realistic, but as you can clearly see, it looks as if it's bending and I'm walking around like it's some sort of sphere or Earth or planet or globe, but really, it's just the same old flat Minecraft with a massive twist to it. So, very cool shader, definitely not as exciting as the Inception one, but of course it is still pretty cool. So let me know what you guys think about this one. I'll go ahead and show you guys what it looks like with the other maps as well. Here we are in the medieval world. So yeah, very light compared to the other one. It's not as crazy, and I can see this being something you might actually like. It's pretty cool. I mean, a lot of these, there's no way you're playing with them, but this one, I can see someone playing with this. It's not too bad at all. And finally, here it is on the modern world with lampposts, trees, and somewhere there are skyscrapers. I'm probably not going in the right. Yeah, let's go back this way. Check what it looks like when you fly around with it. Holy cow. Very, very, very cool. I'm definitely digging it. Very awesome stuff. Let's move on to the next shader pack. This one is called the Hallucination Pack. And oh my goodness! What in the world is going on? Jeez! Oh my goodness, this is crazy! So what this pack does is, if you can't tell, just makes your world roll on top of each other like crazy. I might throw up. I might begin to throw up here. This is definitely one of the weirdest experiences in Minecraft. I cannot even describe this. This is absolutely insane. I have no idea what's going on. No idea what's going on. This is the Hallucinations pack. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the craziest pack of them all. Oh my goodness. It's not gonna make too much of a difference what world I show you this on. Take a look. This is absolutely nuts. So if you guys are digging this one, let me know. What is your favorite one, by the way? We still have one more, but I may as well mention at the end of this video, after you're done watching it all, let me know which one was your favorite, right? Because this is absolutely ridiculous. Oh my goodness, I gotta switch this up. I think I'm gonna throw up. Oh my goodness. And now, for the final pack, this is the Animal Crossing pack. Now, if you've ever seen the game Animal Crossing, it is very, very similar, where the world right in front of you is a little bit rounded off, and then the rest of the world is nice and normal. So it's kind of weird. weird, definitely, it's really weird, but it gets the job done, and it is very, very fun to play with. This one is another one that I can see someone actually using, although it's definitely not as normal as the parabolic shader that I showed you guys. It's still bearable, though. Like, I don't want to throw up right now and curl up into a ball and cry. No. This one is a very, very cool one, and you can actually see up in front of you, which is something that not a lot of the other ones offer. So there we go. Very, very cool. Let's go ahead and see what this thing looks like in other types of worlds. Here is the medieval village with the market and all sorts of walkways and whatnot. So it's really cool. As you walk forward, the trees just like pop up out of the ground. Everything just pops up. It's a pretty cool look, and I definitely understand if you guys would like this one. Although, yes, it is pretty extreme. This is probably the perfect balance between extreme and actually usable. I do like this pack. Definitely not as crazy as the Inception or Hallucination pack, but it gets the job done and it is pretty awesome. So that's that, and whoa. What's going on there? That's kind of weird. Okay, anyways, let's go check out what else we have. So, the city! You can finally see it! I don't think a single one of the shader packs earlier allowed you to see the city, and I'm actually flying around right now, so it's a little bit weird. Oh, you can't even tell I'm using the thing, except when you look under me. It's kind of... What is that? Okay, so that was weird, but anyways, this is what the city looks like, and you can actually see it's a normal looking city. Like I said, none of the other shader packs you could actually tell what I was doing, so there we go. And it's actually lagging like crazy, and I assume it's because of all the glass and stuff, but there we go. So this was the shader packs of Doom of the century. I'm making this up, but very awesome shader packs. So you just apply them like texture packs and they change your world. I don't know how they do it, but it is very, very cool. I am a huge fan of this stuff. So if you guys did enjoy this video, please go ahead and smash that like button. If you'd like to see more stuff just like this, please do let me know. Anyways, I think that just about wraps it up. Also in the comment section, let me know which shader pack was your favorite, or which one you'd actually want to use. Because I know the Hallucination one may be some people's favorite, but there's no way you'd actually want to use that in the games. So, let me know. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, stay frosty, my friends. Peace, guys. See ya. Bye-bye.